By monitoring individual paddocks over a wide range of farms in Western Australia, the Department of Agriculture and Food WA Profitable Crop and Pasture Sequencing Project is working to determine where and when break crops deliver real benefits. The aim is to help growers make sound crop rotation decisions, resulting in a better return on investment in break crops. Alistair Falconer from Coorow in WA's Northern Wheatbelt has been struggling with controlling ryegrass on his property.
Because we're such a cereal dominated operation, the treff land was getting used all through the cereal phase, and then it was also getting used through the canola phase, and we were starting to have real trouble controlling our ryegrass preceding and really relying far too heavily on our post chemicals to control the grass. So we had suspicions that there was treffland resistance there, and the testing through the focus paddock program confirmed our suspicions. So as a result of that, we've changed the way we look at controlling our ryegrass in that focus paddock. Not controlling the ryegrass, that was it was just limiting our yield. It was affecting the grain quality. It was becoming a real headache, given our dryland farming systems, where you know to get the crop in early is the ideal, but if you've got the weed problems to go with it, it makes it very hard to make it a profitable paddock. Basically, we've applied about 6 tonne of lime sand over the last 4 years to increase the pH on that site. It certainly worked well on the radish, and it seems to be working well on the ryegrass. But aside from that, we've changed what chemicals we use and how we use them. Ideally now we do 1 year of canola, then 3 to 4 years of wheat. And we start by, with the canola, we use a propizamide, which is a group of chemical we haven't used before, and make sure we get it really clean in the canola phase, and then windrowed at harvest time. So we capture as much as we can. The canola windrows seem to burn the best. And then from then we use a Sakura the following year cereal, and then probably 2 box of golds, and then a treffland with trilate, just to really try and mix up our chemical groups, and it seems to be working so far. This year we were fortunate enough to be able to do a double knot, and it is as clean as it's ever been, I think. It's made a huge difference to the paddock. It was canola last year and had a very good control. This year it's wheat, and it's as good as it's ever looked. The management of the break crops is hugely important, because if you can get the numbers down in the break crop, you're not putting as much pressure on your cereal crop chemicals, which makes a huge difference, which makes it a lot easier to manage. Oh, we want to make money out of that break crop. That's why we grow canola, because like I said, traditionally we used to grow lupins, and it was very hard to make them profitable out on this heavier country. So the canola, we can make a margin. We're getting the weed benefits, but we're also getting a really good disease break. So it works really well, and it does. We're in a minimum till farming system, and the canola phase seems to break down a lot of that stubble as well, just to make it easier for the machinery to get through the following year.